Hi, my name is David Klein. In this video presentation, I will be catching you up on new features related to the CarSim and TruckSim suspensions. As it has been some time since our last user conference, I will be covering content introduced in versions 2020.1, 2021.0, and 2021.1. First, let me give you an overview of the CarSim and TruckSim suspensions. The vehicle sim technology behind CarSim and TruckSim is used to produce parametric multi-body modules, which can be assembled into various model layouts. Both CarSim and TruckSim include the independent and solid axle modules. A suspension module is installed on a per axle basis. In other words, a suspension module contains both wheels of an axle. The suspension modules are parametric in that they have been designed to accept familiar kinematic and compliance properties as input. These are the kinds of measurements you can get on a CNC rig or from a multi-body modeling tool like Suspension Sim or Atoms. Compliance data for the various suspension modules are similar. The main difference is how the wheel or axle is constrained relative to the sprung mass. The independent suspension module defines the motion of one wheel relative to the sprung mass as a function of jounce and optionally as a secondary function of jounce of the other wheel on the axle. This module is typically used in three ways. First, to model a steered front suspension with a well-defined steering axis, such as an SLA. Second, to model a non-steered multi-link rear suspension. And third, to model a twist beam rear suspension. The twist beam application takes advantage of the secondary independent variable. The solid axle suspension module defines the motion of a rigid axle relative to the sprung mass as a function of axle jounce and axle roll. This module is used for modeling both steered and unsteered solid axle suspensions. With that background in mind, I'd like to discuss suspension features introduced in 2020.1, the virtual steering axis suspension module, and support for inclined springs for solid axles. The virtual steering axis suspension module is unique to CarSim and is the newest module introduced in CarSim 2020.1. This module defines the motion of a wheel relative to the sprung mass as a function of jounce and steering rack travel. This module is used for modeling steered suspensions which have no fixed kingpin geometry, like a strut type which has the lower control arm divided into two separate links. The virtual steering axis module is used with three main screens: suspension, virtual steering axis system kinematics, suspension, virtual steering axis compliance, springs and dampers, and steering, virtual steering axis. Additional new libraries are also available to input the 2D suspension kinematics tables. The virtual steering axis wheel kinematics tables are 2D functions of jounce and steering rack travel. All five wheel kinematics variables, dive, camber, steer, wheel center X, and wheel center Y, are defined as these 2D functions. This allows a rack movement to produce motion about an arbitrary, instantaneous, or virtual axis of rotation rather than a fixed kingpin axis. Two example vehicles were introduced in CarSim 2020.1 that demonstrate the virtual steering axis module: the B-Class Sports Car VSA and the D-Class Sedan VSA. The front suspension of the sports car was created based on a double ball joint strut model we built in Suspension Sim. The front suspension of the sedan was based on the existing CarSim example sedan. Also introduced for 2020.1, for both CarSim and TruckSim, is a solid axle spring option which supports geometric parameters for the spring installations: spring length, front view spring inclination angle, and side view spring inclination angle. This is an optional feature enabled by setting the spring length parameter to be greater than zero. This is similar to the optional geometric parameters for the solid axle damper installations. It's now time to move on to improvements introduced in CarSim and TruckSim 2021.0, a new kingpin rotation angle calculation, and a suspension contribution to steering system inertia. For suspensions which use a fixed kingpin axis and have steer angles defined in vehicle coordinates, the VS Math model converts the steer kinematics from the tables into an equivalent rotation about the inclined kingpin axis. This kingpin rotation angle is then used as a constraint in the multi-body suspension model. This calculation was replaced beginning in version 2021.0 with a more efficient version that does not rely on iteration. Consequently, the model will no longer fail during the run with the error message, "There was a problem in KP constraint," could not calculate the kingpin steer angle. Error handling for the new calculation method occurs at initialization by checking the total inclination of the kingpin axis with respect to vertical and making sure it does not exceed 45 degrees. The new calculation method produces slight differences in simulation results, but these are attributable to the accuracy of the new calculation compared to the previous iterative calculation, which would produce results only as accurate as its solution tolerance allowed. Additionally, beginning in version 2021.0, the VS Math model can automatically calculate a suspension contribution to the steering system inertia and add it to the user-provided steering system inertia value. This feature is enabled based on the setting of the parameter opt iGear in, which may be set with a checkbox on the appropriate steering system screen. When opt iGear in is off, the suspension contribution to steering system inertia is not calculated automatically. Your value of iGear in is used as is. You can calculate the suspension contribution yourself and include it in the specified iGear in. Alternatively, you can decide to neglect the suspension contribution. When opt iGear in is on, the kingpin geometry, steered unsprung mass and inertias, linkage kinematics, and steering gear kinematics are used to calculate an inertia term which represents the rotation of the steered unsprung masses around the left and right kingpin axes. This term is referenced to the steering gear input rotation and is added to the iGear in value you provide. This means your steering inertia value should not include the effect of unsprung masses rotating about the kingpins. The total steering system inertia, consisting of your value plus the calculated value from the suspension, is output with the output variable iSteerGear, or the echo file keyword iGearInTote. The value is in general not constant due to the kinematics. The echo file value corresponds to the value at the time the echo file was written. In our final segment, I will be covering the suspension features introduced in versions 2021.1. 2D table support for solid axle kinematics, and widespread 2D support for spring, damper, jounce stop, and rebound stop kinematics. For version 2021.1, the solid axle suspension module has expanded support for 2D axle kinematics tables. Previously, only the solid axle lateral movement could be given as a 2D table. Now, the other three solid axle kinematics functions, dive, steer, and longitudinal movement, can be given as 2D. To demonstrate these 2D tables, I used a suspension sim model to make some measurements. You can see here that we've also updated the solid axle kinematics screen to support the new 2D options. This screenshot also shows the custom settings box used for some new solid axle inertial properties, the pitch inertia, IAYY, and the longitudinal CG offset of the axle, XCG axle. These two parameters are also new for 2021.1. Additionally, the solid axle lateral movement table supports a new option controlled by a checkbox on the solid axle lateral movement screen. When this is on, the solid axle lateral movement table completely specifies the kinematical lateral displacement of the axle center point relative to the sprung mass. When this is off, the solid axle lateral movement table contributes partly to the kinematical lateral displacement of the axle center. There is also a lateral contribution from the axle jounce in the direction implied by axle roll. Off is the default setting and corresponds to the definition used in previous versions. Moving on, as of 2021.1, the CarSim virtual steering axis suspension now supports 2D tables of jounce and steering rack travel for the jounce and rebound stop kinematics. Previously, these could be entered only as 1D tables of jounce. The additional relationship with rack travel allows the jounce and rebound stops to potentially contribute to the rack force from the tie rods. The two example vehicles in CarSim that use the virtual steering axis, B-Class Sports Car VSA and D-Class Sedan VSA, have been updated to include 2D jounce and rebound stop data. Additionally, the independent and solid axle suspensions now support 2D tables of jounce and jounce other side for the spring and damper compressions as well as the jounce and rebound stop kinematics. Previously, these only supported 1D functions of jounce. This is most useful for the 2018 twist beam model, which uses the independent suspension with 2D kinematics tables. The example vehicle for the 2018 twist beam model has been updated to use the 2D table type for these. For the solid axle application, the new 2D tables provide another way to enter the geometric effects of the springs and dampers. we have updated the suspension help file to explain the various modeling options. Well, I've now got you up to speed with the latest improvements to the CarSim and TruckSim suspensions. To summarize, we covered the virtual steering axis and solid axle incline spring option from 2020.1, the kingpin rotation and steering system inertia from 2021.0, and finally, the new 2D suspension tables for 2021.1. Thank you for your attention. For more information, check out the other videos on our mechanical simulation YouTube channel and our website, carsim.com.